In today's tutorial, we're going
to... So we can set up the...
Is Zoho Marketing Automation confusing the hell out of you? Well, you're not alone. There's a ton of people out there who feel the same way. So make sure you tune into these tutorials to make sure that you get your system set up properly at the start. In today's tutorial, we're going to be talking about complex journeys. So let's log in and I'll see you there.
All right, now that we're logged in, we are going to create a more advanced journey from the last one I showed you. So let's go over here on the left-hand side, click the Journeys tab, and that's going to take us to the All Journey section. Let's create a new journey in the top right over here. So we'll click that. And then instead of using one of these pre-built templates, so for example, we could scroll down here and look at one of these advanced lead nurturing campaigns. It is pretty in-depth. There's a lot of stuff going on here, and I'll quickly describe this. We're not going to be creating this one, just so you know what's happening. So we have the triggers up here, which is on list entry or on reaching a specific stage, then it's going to hit an email. Now there's going to be a response over here that's going to be tracked on what the recipient is actually going to do, whether they're unresponsive and they just don't open it, whether it's been opened, whether the link's been clicked, or there's another specific link that's been clicked here as well. So you see a bit more information there. And then each of these options goes down to something else. So you can build that up. And over here, we're actually working on the lead scoring on this section right here. And then this is combining and merging into one, and it's sending the second nurturing message. And then again, if it's either of these two, it would follow this path and go down here to this other response. Now, alternatively, if they clicked a very specific link, then they'd automatically go down here and they go to get another lead score over here, and then they'd move on to another journey. So this one's pretty straightforward, showing that they are very engaged with your content. They click the thing you wanted them to click. Now, if we continue on through this path, we have this option. They'll go through this process again, and then they'll get assigned more scores. These leads will be merged. These paths will be merged, and it will be assigned a tag. So this is a fairly complex and convoluted lead nurturing campaign. So we're not going to be creating anything this complex. We'll just talk about a few more options you have when creating your campaigns. So let's exit out of here. Let's go back and create our own blank journey. So we're going to just name it another test. And let's create it. So we're going to have one trigger. We're just going to say on form submission, and we are going to select any sign up form. Doesn't really matter. Let's just select that. Then we want to select the right process, which is send an email. Now here we actually want to remove this delay. Let's just get rid of it. Save. So there is no delay over here. And then we are going to add in a new content piece here. So message one, let's just all copy that so that we can continue to move on. And as usual, let's just continue on if we can. Let's just select a pre-designed template. A thank you. Nothing crazy again. We're just going to select this one and we're going to click next and next and then save and proceed. So that's our first message one. And we still have, looks like that needs to be sent for review. We don't really care about that right now. So we're going to skip that. But we are going to come down here and go to custom reminder loop, which is going to give us a few different options. So now that we have this response trigger over here, we can actually set this up so that there is a new content piece that goes out, a new email after 1 hour if they do nothing with it. So now that we've exited out of that, we got back to this page. We see that there's this unresponsive over here. So we can set up the content to do something else here. So we're going to send out another email there, depending on whether it's unresponsive. We'll set up another email in case it's been opened. We'll set up another email in case it's been clicked. So we can, again, choose these options. Let's get back into this edit mode over here. We're going to send email. So we are going to throw that one there. Now that's connected. We want to send another email to this one. And then we want a final email depending on the link click. So we have these three emails that are going to come out. We also have the option over here on the response to add a path for specific clicks. So if something specific happens, then we want to bypass maybe a few different options as we showed in the previous advanced lead nurturing campaign. All right, and now that we're here, we can actually, let's create a merge down here depending on these two, if I can get it in there. So if we scroll down over here, we want to select these two. So because these have both been opened emails, maybe we want to send off one final email depending on how this resulted. So let's do that. And in the meantime, we may actually, you know what? Let's just remove that for now. Scroll that down. We actually want to, let's see, add a score. So we want to add a score over here and let's connect that to that. So we want to add a score so we can configure this. We can set, oh, well, they open this. Let's give them another 15 points. And so that way they just get a few more points in our lead marketing score. And now over here, we have this final email that we would send out, and we can continue on this as long as we want to go. So I'm just going to add a few more items here. I'm actually going to create a task over here. Let's add a task in the CRM based off of this individual. So let's configure that now so you can see what that looks like. So we're going to create a task in CRM for both existing new leads and contacts. So let's say, yes, we have fields mapped that one over there, and we're going to map to leads here. And we're going to say, because maybe this is a lead campaign, we're going to add another one over here. Let's just say phone is equal to phone. Now this information is going to be pushed back and forth, and now we want to actually create the CRM task itself. So we're going to say new interested lead, and we're going to just make this a follow-up task. So let's just say active four, and then not started, priority is highest, and the description is please follow up with lead. They are currently engaging with our content. Now we can assign all tasks to one owner. We can assign owner by round robin method. So in this case, it might depend on what that user is, or alternatively, we can go into the Zoho CRM itself, and when this task is created, we can assign it to that individual based on what that email is. So we can do, there's a lot of other things we can do here to actually set up this on the CRM side and set up more workflows. We're just trying to push this task over so it goes to those individuals, but it is something that we can do from the marketing automation piece. So let's just click save. Select the owner, user one. Let's click save here. We're gonna click done. And we want this person, let's say if they're unresponsive after the first email, we actually wanna go back to the end of journey over here, and let's just close it out. Is there an option? There. On the process over here, we can exit them from the journey. We no longer want them in there, let's say. So we have that option. And so at this point, we have a more advanced journey as well. And as you can see, we have from sort form submission up here to all of these different pieces down here. And we could continue building onto this if we so chose. We could even send internal notification email to someone on our team, let's say. If once a CRM task has been created, we could configure this to send out an email as well to either the journey owner or even to the CRM owner. So there is a billion different combinations and things we can do here. So I recommend you just start playing around with it, understanding what these journeys are capable of. And it is a lot of stuff. So bear with us. I know this was a very long, but hopefully informative video. So make sure that you look at these tabs on the left, play around with it, send out some test campaigns to yourself and your teammates so you can get a better understanding of it. As always, please subscribe to our channel below, comment and like our videos. We want to make sure this content is getting out to everyone who needs help with Zoho Marketing Automation, as well as any of the other Zoho tools. And feel free to follow us on our other social media like Facebook and Instagram. We're building an awesome community, and we can't wait to see you there. Bye for now.